Hey guys, it's July. So, well, it's not July when you're seeing this, but it's going to be July. How exciting! You know what that means, right? That means I'm moving into my new planner, which I actually forgot about when I did my my 4th of July spread. But yeah, you might be watching this before that happens or after. I can't remember when this is posting, but. If you haven't seen that video yet, when you see my 4th of July spread, I take pages from another month, and because I was borrowing them out of the Mosaics planner, and I was like, I'm just going to take them from like November because they match the dates in July. And what I didn't realize, or I forgot, is that my planner starts in July. Duh. Anyway, this currently page is from the Teresa Collins planner that I've been using all year. And the reason I'm using this one is because it has this on the back. I'm filming this before this week, by the way, so that's why there's no writing on it. But yeah, so I didn't want to, like, a lot of my planner this year has been gluing pages together with this, and it's getting pretty thick, so I wanted to kind of try to avoid that. Besides, I really do like these pages on the Teresa Collins planner, so yeah. So today I don't really have too many ideas. I have one big idea, and then I don't know what I'm doing as far as stickers or anything. I have these three washi tapes, which are so cute, right? I am going to cut this one down so it's the same size as these, but also I'm gonna make stripes. So I thought it would be fun to make three stripes here and three stripes here, kind of coming down vertically, but I can't put it right over the black because it is see-through. So I'm going to need to put it on label paper first and then cut it. So I am going to do something else with these two, but stay tuned to find out what that is. It's going to be kind of cool, I hope. And then as far as stickers go, I don't know what I'm doing with that, but the first thing I'm going to do is cut this down, and let me just see. All right. I'm going to just attempt to like wing it here. I don't know if this is gonna work, but let's try it. That's about right. So if you have washi tape that's not the size you want, you can always cut it down. Let's see if I did it right. Ooh, look at that. Almost perfect. Awesome. You can always cut it down and make a new washi tape. You can even make really skinny washi tape with this stuff. You can do lots of things with washi tape. Okay, so I am going to, like I said, I'm gonna put each of these pieces on label paper, and then I'm gonna cut them, and then I'm gonna make stripes at the top. But I'll fast forward this part where I do this, and then we'll go to the stripe part. Okay, so I had to use the scissors because I kind of messed up on the paper trimmer a little bit, but here we have three stripes. And I, like I said, I think I'm gonna put them one here, here, and here, and then the same thing on the other side. I thought it would like just create something bright and colorful at the top of the page without using stickers. So why not just try that out? I think what I'll do is just sort of take these. I'm going to take these on the back and use a pencil to sort of measure these out where to cut them. And then I'm going to cut them, like I said, into strips. And then we'll go from there. Okay, I forgot to film that part. Sorry about that. Isn't this cute? Oh my gosh, I love it so far. I think it's so cool. I know you're gonna ask me where I got this washi tape. I got it at Go Wild in the bag of stuff that Michaels gave us. So I know that Michaels carries it or did carry it. I think it's probably Recollections brand, but I can't guarantee that they still carry this. It's so cute though. It's like tie-dye. Look at that. It's so pretty and vibrant. Love it. So I told you I was going to do something else that was kind of cool. So I decided to bring these colors down to the bottom here. I'm going to create a mosaic. This has been something I've been wanting to do for a long time. I've seen people do it before in their planner, and I do want to do it with like extra stickers that I have that I don't like. I want to cut up and make mosaics, but I haven't done that yet, and I thought it would be fun to do it with washi tape, just to try it out. So I'm gonna cut it into little pieces and kind of just make like a, I don't know. It's just gonna take on a life of its own, honestly. So I don't really know what it's gonna look like at the bottom, but I am gonna kind of like do like red and then green and then purple and then maybe back, maybe just red, green, purple like that. I don't know. So, hang out and see what I do. Okay, that took forever, and my desk is an absolute wreck, and I've got washi all over my hands. But you guys, it's not very often that I'm like blown away by something I do. This is freaking awesome. I love this so much. I can't even tell you how much I love this. I'm gonna have to like do the currently stuff in here. I have to figure out how to do that. I may or may not use boxes. I might just write it in. And then, so the problem I have is that like all the color is here and here, and then the bottom of the page, I have no idea what I'm gonna do there to kind of like bring some of the color down. Or maybe, actually, now that I'm thinking about it, maybe the best thing to do at this point is to do all black and white for the rest of it and have that be the only color on the page. How cool would that be? I think I'm gonna do that. Like, it'd be really fun to bring in more color, but I think like it would really emphasize it if I don't. So I think I'm gonna try it without and see how it goes. All right. Totally freaking love it. But I would only recommend doing that if you have a lot of time on your hands, because it really did take me a long time when I should be making other videos, but I wanted to do it, so I did it. All right. So now I never really like this notes here, but I might leave it this time. I hate that this is peach. I don't want this peach down here. That does not match at all. Let me pause this and grab some black and white stuff. Okay, I really do think I'm gonna let the colors speak for themselves. I'm going to let that design speak for itself and then go with very understated for the rest of the page. So this is a page I pulled out of an undated big happy planner. And this is back when they used to list these things out. And I'm glad I have some of these and that I saved them. That's why I don't throw out any pages. You know, you can always like recycle and reuse. So I'm going to just cut this out. And then I'm obviously gonna have to like put some here and some here. And then I'm just gonna fill it out with you guys. Right, so I'm just gonna glue these down, but I think I wanna put currently here instead of notes. Don't know what that's gonna look like. Maybe on like a black box sticker. Or with just black letters across here. Let me pull out my letter sticker book. That might be a good idea. my alphabet book and just grab like some basic black letters. Not those, these ones. Let me see if I have enough. Well, probably not. I use these a lot. No, okay. I could use these. They're not that great, but gold. Yeah, the rest are not black. Let's look in the fun alphabet sticker book. I know there's those cursive black ones, which I don't think are the look I'm going for. There's these though. Oh, I could use these. All right, let me use these ones. So I'm gonna do my ruler trick. Not my ruler trick, I didn't make it up. I actually forget where I heard it. I feel like my friend Marielle, Mom and a Girl with Plans on Instagram, I feel like she taught it to me, but honestly, it's been so long that I've been doing this, I don't remember. But I'm just going to put the letter stickers here and then I can easily center it on the page. Okay, so that's not perfect, but you know, it's okay. So I am going to just put these down and then we're going to fill it out. And then I don't know what I'm gonna do at the bottom. Maybe some black like icons here, and then maybe like a black quote here. We'll see. But for now, I'm gonna put these down. I'm just using Tombow, sometimes it gets a little stuck. Tombow Mono Adhesive Roller, that's always in my Amazon shop. I wonder if I wanna, yeah, I think I wanna bring this up to here. Okay, now we can fill this part out. So I'm currently reading White Fragility, because I'm really trying to learn more about like white privilege and racial inequality and stuff like that. So I just started it. I've been really busy and haven't had a whole lot of time to read, so I haven't gotten very far, but so far it's pretty good. I would recommend it. Watching. So I'm not watching much because I got rid of my cable. I'm just gonna write not much TV. I got rid of my cable and upgraded my internet, which is awesome because my videos upload like really fast now. I'm just gonna write cut Comcast. I can still watch Netflix and like Amazon Prime and stuff. I just haven't really been doing it. Cooking. I've been making a lot of turkey burgers because I am on Weight Watchers, and the 99% fat-free ground turkey is free, and I really like turkey burgers, so I've been making those a lot. Eating clean, and then I'm just gonna write Weight Watchers. I'm really trying, but I'm really not taking much weight off, honestly. I don't have much to lose, and that could be part of it, but I have maybe about 7-8 pounds I want to take off, and I've lost like 5 so far, so at least that's good. I am loving doing Morning Meltdown 100, and that is a workout program that I'm doing. It's on Beachbody On Demand. And I'm doing it with a friend of mine. And like, so we check in with each other. It's a really good program. It's only 30 minutes. So it goes really fast. And like, there's a couple of people who modify and stuff. So it's like really easy. You don't have to do what the main person's doing. I really like it. I like the, I think I've talked about this with you guys before anyway. I like the trainer. She's really good and motivating and not annoying. And the whole thing just goes quick and it's not annoying. That's why I like it. I am sore pretty much every day, but I'm doing my best. I'm not doing full on what they're doing. Like I said, I'm modifying it because I have some injuries too. But I really like it. It's not hard at all. And there's 100 workouts. It's quite a commitment. I'm going to try to get through all of them. Okay, so I am dreaming of a fit body. I have been pretty fit in the past, and it's just kind of gotten downhill. So I want to get back there. I want to get past what I was too. Feeling ambitious, because, as you know, I quit my job, and I'm really feeling like I can do anything I want now. So I'm really gonna like look into different avenues and different things. So I'm feeling ambitious about that. Listening. I've been listening to 80s music with my boyfriend. We have this game we play where we'll like put a song on and the other person has to guess what the song is like really fast. Like we'll only play a snippet. I beat him like every time. I'm really good at it. He's not as good. I think it's funny, but we have fun doing that. Okay, so celebrating Allie and Heather's birthday. They are turning 23 in July on the 15th. Going to Outer Banks with my family, and my boyfriend's coming too, and it's like a family reunion. We go every maybe 5 years or so. Like my Florida family comes up and we meet there and get a big house. So it's gonna be a lot of fun. I thought it might be canceled, but it's not canceled. So that makes me really happy that we can still go. So, and then I am just crafting the usual. I really don't do any other crafts except for planning. So I'm just gonna write planner spreads here. Yeah, I'm gonna run out of space. That's why I paused. But I can go off onto the page. Okay, this looks like it's pulling up. I don't know why. Stick that down a little bit better. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Now, down here, like I said, I think I just need some black icons. Where can I get black icons? I can color some in. Why don't I do that? That's easier than like looking through all my sticker books. So let me get let's see. How about the pastel sticker book? The Mega Pastel. And I'm gonna go in the back here and I'm going to take some of these. Where are they? These little icons. Here's triangles. Do I want triangles? Well, I thought there were circles here too. Those are letters. It's hard to see. Letters. All right. Well, thought there were circles. I don't really need circles though. I can use triangles. So what I'm gonna do is this is a trick I learned from my friend Plan with Elise on Instagram. If you're not following her, what are you doing with your life? Make sure you follow her. She has some great tips. And really, really pretty spreads. So I'm just gonna take this. I'm gonna do it on these ones because I don't like this color that much. Although these ones probably it'll honestly it either way it'll be fine. She does it with a black Sharpie. Maybe I should do that. Maybe that'll be a better option. Anyway, if like she loves black spreads and using black in her planner, so if she needs black like icons or black stickers, she just takes a Sharpie and does this. How many do I need? It's a really easy way to get black stickers when you don't have them. I think like pretty much all of us need black stickers sometimes. So, well, I didn't color that one all the way. And you would never know that you made them yourself. Look at this. Right? It's like perfect, except I did not cover the peach circle all the way, which is ridiculous because it's not that big. So that's just a little trick for you. Don't be afraid to alter your stickers in a lot of ways. I know I always say don't be afraid to cut your stickers, but also you can alter them. You can color them. You can rip them. You can, what else can you do with stickers? Layer them, obviously. But there's a lot of things you can do to switch it up, to make them what you want them to be. Okay, so I will write my goals in there. But before I do that, maybe I'll cover that and use that same. I don't usually cover these, I just usually leave it. But what if I use that same, the same letters for this section, and I just wrote goals or like to do. Let me see. That's not the book. It's the fun alphabets one. Me grab some label paper and put it on there. I know it's gonna be like, maybe I'd do white out. I don't know. I hate the thought of doing white out. Honestly, I don't have five goals. I think I'm going to take one of these off. I was just putting it there because I wanted to just cover that, but I'm going to white this out because then I can take this whole section and like cover it with label paper. That way it won't look weird, I think. So let's try that. Okay, so I just cut a piece of label paper and also poked my finger. Ouch. I'm just going to cover this. I know it's not ideal. You can see the difference in color, but it's going to have to do. I could use a piece of regular paper that would match this better, but I think, let me just try it. I think you're going to see, well, maybe you don't. Okay, let's try that this time. Just because I don't want it to like ruin my spread. I don't always like care, but this time it's like, I don't know. I feel like it's really pretty and I just want to like, I don't know. I don't want it to be messed up by a different color. So that looks better, but you know, I have to glue it in, which is fine. Okay, so let me just glue this on. So you can use regular paper too, which I like never do, but you certainly can because I thought you would see through it, but you don't. Okay, and that matches much better. So now I am going to take these letters and spell out goals. And that way it's just going to like pull it all together and match what I've got going on at the top of the page. Probably isn't going to be super centered, but I didn't feel like putting it on the ruler. I'm just going to go with it. That O is a bit wonky. Letter stickers are sometimes really hard to work with, but I do like them. I use them all the time. It's just sometimes difficult. That turned out pretty good, though. Okay. And I know there's a spaced out more than these, but you know, I'll live with it. So let me just write in my goals for the month of July. So my first goal is to have a better work-life balance because I have been working way too much and I'm not taking enough time for myself or for my family or my friends. I find that I am just always working. And then if I don't have anything to do on the weekend, I'm working. Like, so I need to like work on that balance so that I'm happier, because sometimes like I feel yucky if I've had like the whole weekend and I've just been working. Like, I need more in my life than that. So, I need to work on that a little bit because it's hard for me to stop. I'm a workaholic, you guys. What can I say? So, I'm just gonna write better work-life balance because if you've ever worked for yourself, it's like it's kind of difficult to get that correct balance, and I think it takes a while. So, I'm gonna work on that. And as like related to this goal, better schedule. How do I say that? A more productive schedule, I should say. Like, I'm getting things done, but I kind of want to make like schedule them better. And I kind of have been telling you guys this for a while, and I'm still not like really doing it. Like, I really want to work on my schedule and how I'm spending my time. Okay. Keep exercising daily, which might be hard when we go on vacation. I'm gonna try. It's only half an hour, so maybe if I get up early, haha. I always say I'm gonna work out on vacation, and that does not happen, but I'm gonna try this time. Allie will be with me. She might do it too. And then finish the kitchen. I bought new knobs, I bought a new backsplash, and they've been sitting there. Again, work-life balance, right? I've been spending a lot of time working and not enough time on other things, and I really could use. Ooh, my writing went downhill a little bit. I really could use, like, I could finish this kitchen. I want to finish this kitchen. Okay, so now we need some black quotes. One black quote here. I need to get rid of this peach. So I think what I'm gonna do, now that I saw that that paper matches so well, I think I'm gonna take another piece. I don't know if I have like a big enough piece though that doesn't have any lines in it. Let me think. Okay, I found this piece of filler paper that has no lines, no dots, and no graph. That's really actually rare for the Happy Planner, so I'm surprised I have it, but it matches the color because it is the Happy Planner. So, I'm just gonna cut that to fit, and then we're gonna find a quote to go there. So, let's put this down. You could also use a glue stick, but it does warp your page a little bit, so I tend to not use them if I can help it, even though they're easier. All right, let me get my eraser and just erase that little pencil line there. And it's really bugging me what happened here with my writing. I'm really good at writing in straight lines. For some reason, it did not work that way this time, and that never happens. Also, it's bugging me how goals is over so far, but I'm gonna let it go. Maybe I'll put a piece of black washi tape there. That's an idea. Let me grab a piece. Just so I can separate that, it'll make it look more centered, I guess. Hopefully. let's go with maybe just a black polka dot. I'm almost out of this. This is my favorite washi. It's still gonna look off center, isn't it? Okay, that's okay. I'm gonna put this down anyway because it's gonna cover where that paper ended to make it look seamless. And then we're gonna put something here. So whenever something's off center, what you can do is you can put something next to it, like a sticker or a drawing or something right here to make it look centered. I do that all the time, like especially when I'm writing in my planner and it looks off. I'll put like a little doodle or a star or like a little sticker there to just balance it out. That did not go all the way to the top. Wait, that's annoying. I cut it short, but I'm gonna leave it. Maybe I'll just take my Sharpie and just color that in. About just a little pen here. There, now you never know. Okay, so I'm gonna get a quote for here. I'm gonna get a sticker for here. I know this is long, hopefully this isn't too long, and but we'll get it done. So let me pause this and grab those. Okay, in the Be Yourself sticker book, there is this big Plan Your Dream sticker. I think this will fit. If it doesn't, we will make it fit. There, it does fit. I'm just gonna place that right down there because I'm all about dreams lately and my goals, and I'm really excited about stuff, so that makes sense. Now let's see about here. Let's see if there's something little in this book we can put here. We're not gonna put today has been canceled because that does not make sense. Because we're not canceled anymore, you guys. We're opened up. We're yellow in Pennsylvania. But, you know, we still have to be careful. How about glasses? There we go. Oh, they're kind of big. Or I could tilt them. How about that? Okay. I think that's cute. It's a little crowded looking, but I still think it's cute. So that is it. There are the peach lines up here, but I think they're so understated that it doesn't really bother me. So I am just gonna leave them there. I feel like if I did anything to like cover them up or call attention to it, it just might be a little more noticeable. So I think I'm just gonna leave it. All right, you guys, I love it. Let me know in the comments down below what you think. This is probably my favorite Currently page ever. So thanks for sticking it out with me. I'll see you in my next video. Have a great day. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.